Hello dear students, today we will continue the same topic triangles which we discussed in the last video. In the last video we discussed about triangle, their introduction, classifications of triangle and what is congruent triangle. Now today we will continue the congruence of triangle. Here are some criterias related to the congruent triangles. There are 5 criterias. With the help of this criteria we will prove the two triangles are congruent. Now I will show you some slides related to these 5 criterias. So criteria for congruence of triangle. First criteria is side angle side. Second, angle side angle. Angle angle side. Side side side. And the last one is RHS, right angle hypotenuse side. Now the first criteria is side angle side congruence rule. So the two triangles are congruent if two sides and the included angle of a triangle are equal to the sides and the included angle of the other triangle. So the figure, in this figure there are two figures ABC and PQR. Let's see how side angle side will use. So in triangle ABC and triangle PQR we have given AC is equals to PR and angle C equals to angle R and BC equals to QR. So then we can say the two triangles are congruent by side angle side congruence rule. Next we have second rule, angle side angle congruence rule. So we can say the two triangles are congruent if two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to two angles and the included side of other triangle. So the two figures are ABC and DEF. In this figure we have given that angle A is equals to angle D and AC equals to DF and angle C is equals to angle F. So here it is clear that two angles included one side. Then we can say the two triangles are congruent by angle side angle congruence rule. Next we have angle angle side congruence rule. So the two triangles are congruent if two angles and the non-included side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and the non-included side of other triangle. So look at this figure. In this figure we have angle A equals to angle P, angle B equals to angle Q and the non-included side is BC equals to QR. It is clear from here that the two angles and non-included sides, then we can say the two triangles are congruent by angle angle side congruence rule. Next, side 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 congruence rule. So if three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. So in this figure, triangle ABC and in triangle PQR we have AB equals to PQ, BC equals to QR and CA equals to RP. Then we can say the two triangles are congruent by side 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 congruence rule. Next we have the last rule, RHS congruence rule. So if in two right triangles the hypotenuse and one side of one triangle are equal to the hypotenuse and one side of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Here the figure ABC and DEF. So in triangle ABC and triangle DEF we have angle B equals to angle E is equals to 90 degree and we have AC equals to DF, BC equals to EF. Then we can say the two triangles are congruent to each other by RHS congruence rule. So I hope you will understand these all topics very clearly. Now, that's it for today's video. Thank you.